تيتينا قال لنا لهجتك من اللي جيتو افتح ده كل حال هاللي نمليك.
Obviously, it doesn't mean literally feeding you.
ما تفسرش obviously literally تتمر من هالق.
It means that it, as just I just mentioned, it fulfills you, it satisfies you.
ما تفسر اللي تمليك أو تسatisfy.
Now, it also not only does it fulfill you and fill you up.
ما مش بس تسatisfy أو تمليك.
It also answers all of your questions.
Almost.
Like sometimes when I have questions, I usually open the scripture and I usually find the answers in there.
Importante kolli xi mistoqsijiet, niftaħ l-iskrittura u hemmhekk fejn se jitweġiba li għandi bżonn.
Also a few times the services, everywhere is answers.
U anke is-servizz ħafna drabi waqt is-servizz nieħdu tweġiba tal-mistoqsijiet tagħna.
You just have to listen and make sure that you read it because you're not going to get the answers by just sitting at home and saying, oh, yes, that's the answer.
Imma trid tisma' u titqara x'hux se tieħu tweġibiet jekk inti toqgħod id-dar u ma tiftaħx is-skrittura.
That's why it's very important to read the scriptures.
Għalhekk importanti li naqraw l-iskrittura.
And it's important that you read it every day.
Importanti li naqrawha ta' kuljum.
Because you never know that day that it may help you.
Għax ma tafx meta se jkun proprju dak il-ġurnata fejn ħatejnek.
In conclusion, I wanted to say that you should keep on reading it every day and try your best.
Konkludi billi naqrawha ta' kuljum u nagħmlu l-qalmu tagħna biex naqrawha ta' kuljum.
I am going to read according to the book from the book of Romans, chapter 11, verses 1 to 10. I ask then, has God rejected his own people, the nation of Israel? Of course not. I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham and a member of the tribe of Benjamin. No, God has not rejected his own people, whom he chose from the very beginning. Do you realize what the scriptures say about this? Elijah, the prophet, complained to God about the people of Israel and said, Lord, they have killed your prophets and torn down your altars. I am the only one left, and now they are trying to kill me too. And do you remember God's reply? He said, No, I have 7,000 others who have never bowed down to Baal. It is the same today for a few of the people of Israel. Have remained faithful because of God's grace, his undeserved kindness in choosing them. And since it is through God's kindness, then it is not by their good works. For in that case, God's grace would not be what it really is, free and undeserved. So this is the situation. Most of the people of Israel have not found the favor of God they are looking for so earnestly. A few have, the ones God has chosen, but the hearts of the rest were hardened. As the scriptures say, God has put them into a deep sleep. To this day, he has shut their eyes so they do not see, and closed their ears so they do not hear. Likewise, David said, let their bountiful table become a snare, a trap that victims. Let their blessings come, and let them get what they deserve. Let their eyes go blind so they cannot see, and let their backs be bent forever.
Amen. Praise God. Amen.
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 Good morning, brethren.
Good morning.
It seems that always, I mean, God has his own way of doing things. Sorry, Mark. He has his way of doing things, God himself.
Alla nifsu għandu l-modi tiegħu kif jaħdem.
And today's service was a very good start-up for this sermon.
Is-servizz kien bidu eċċellenti għal din il-predika.
In fact, as we We'll see the title on the screen.
Infatti, kif naraw it-titlu fuq l-screen?
Zach is the operator of my PowerPoint.
Zach sa jkun qiegħed iħaddem il-PowerPoint.
So he is still at it. But we will, you know, there it is. Praise God. And this is really what we need to hear today.
Dan hu li għandna bżonn nisimgħu llum.
There is a remnant according to grace.
Hemm il-fdal skont il-grazzja.
This was the kind of question that the early Christians.
Din hija t-tip ta' mistoqsija li l-Kristjani fl-ewwel knisja
were asking that, amongst themselves.
Kienu qegħdin isaqsu bejn ieħor.
Thinking that the church had now replaced Israel.
Meta kienu qed jaħsbu li l-Knisja ħadet post Israel.
This principle we call the replacement theology.
Jissejja replacement theology dan il-ħsieb.
Well, in fact, Paul is stating very clearly.
Imma naraw illi Pawlu qiegħed jiddikjara b'mod ċar ħafna.
That this is not the case.
Li dan mhuwiex minnu.
Israel is being dealt uniquely by God.
Alla qiegħed jaħdem b'mod uniku ma' Israel.
They have been out of the picture temporarily.
Għal żmien temporanju qegħdin barra mill-istampa.
Until us Gentiles are saved.
Sakemm aħna l-ġentili nkunu salvati.
So this is good news.
Allora din bil-forsi hija aħbar tajba.
And it's very important.
Huwa importanti ħafna.
That we know who we are as a church.
Li nkunu nafu aħna min aħna bħala knisja.
And this is what Romans 11 will do for us.
U dan illi qed jgħidilna Pawlu f'Rumani 11.
God had made some spectacular promises with the people of God, with the Jews.
Allah amen wediet eccellenti mal-poplu ludi.
And they still belong to them.
U dawn għadhom tagħhom.
And even to us.
U tagħna wkoll.
So there are the promises of salvation.
Allora hemm il-wediet ta' salvazzjoni.
The promises of blessing, we can see this on the screen.
Hemm il-barkiet. Il-weda tal-barkiet.
The promises of spiritual leadership amongst nations.
U hemm il-weda ta' tmexxija spiritwali fil-nazzjonijiet kollha.
In fact, this is what God had promised with his people, with his chosen people.
Fil-fatt dan kien illi Alla wiegħed lill-ġens magħżul.
And these promises still stand.
U dawn il-wediet għadhom fis-seħħ issa.
But unfortunately the nation of Israel has rejected its messiah.
Imma il-lut irriġettaw dan il-messaġġ tal-Messija.
The only one in whom these blessings, these promises can be fulfilled.
L-unika persuna, il-Messija, fejn isibu l-fulfillment il-wediet kollha.
They were the chosen people.
Daw kienu il-poplu magħżul.
Through whom these promises should have been fulfilled.
Fihom setgħu jiġu fis-seħħ dawn il-wediet.
But they fell back.
Imma waqa' kollox.
They rejected the Messiah.
Ma ċċettawx lill-Messija.
Remember what the Old Testament calls the Jews.
Ftakru il-lut kif huma msejħa fit-Testament l-Antik.
Stiff-necked people.
Nies ta' rashom qiebsa.
In fact, I was in Jerusalem and I could confirm it.
Jiena kont Jerusalem u nista' nikkonferma dan.
Had some good experiences in Jerusalem.
Kellna experiences bi Jerusalem.
Some, I had a meeting with a rabbi.
Kelli laqa ma' rabbi.
Which wasn't so good.
Ma' rabbi li ma kienieċ tajba.
Not good at all.
Xejn affattu.
In fact, I don't know why, how come they did not stone me there.
Ma nafx kif ma tefawlix il-ġebel.
The only thing I did was, I came here to follow the footsteps of Jesus.
Kull ma għetijen kien, jiena ġejta hawnhekk biex nimxi fil-passi ta' Ġesu.
Oh, and he was going to turn into Saul. you know, before Paul. But anyway, what's going to happen to Israel? Is God cancelling his promises with the people of Israel? Did he cast them off forever? Did he choose us now instead of them? And in verse 1, Paul says, he communicates a characteristic strong negative. Certainly not. Certainly not. So the early Christians in the Church of Rome, you know, they were a bit trying to play with doctrine and trying to make conclusions. I was going to say that should encourage us, because not only Maltese do that. We shouldn't be encouraged to do that. But Paul, yes, wrote this letter to them because there were these.
Imma Paolo kiteb din l-ittra lil dan in-nazzja ma x'kien hemm dawn il-kwistjonijiet.
And he gives us three reasons for this wrong idea of regarding the nation of Israel.
U Paolo jagħtina tliet raġunijiet rigward dawn l-affarijiet illi kienu qegħdin.
As you can see on the screen, there is a remnant according to grace, which is the first 10 verses of chapter 11.
Mela l-ewwel 10 versi jirrigwardaw il-fdal skont il-grazzja.
There are benefits from Israel's unbelief.
Hemm il-benefiċċji mill-fatt li Israel ma baqgħux temmen.
That's where we come in.
Fejn nidħlu aħna.
Praise God.
Nirringrazzjaw lil Alla ta' dan.
If it wasn't for that, we wouldn't be here.
Kieku ma kienx għal dan il-fatt aħna ma nkunux qegħdin hawn.
And there is a future for the entire nation, Israel.
Imbagħad hemm il-futur għan-nazzjon kollu.
So practically now, which is these three chapters, chapter 9, 10, and 11.
Mela kif konna qegħdin naraw fil-kapitli 9, 10 u 11
represent Israel's past.
Qed jirrappreżentaw il-passat ta' l-Israel,
which is God's, regarding God's sovereign choice,
li jirrigwardja l-għażla sovrana ta' Alla.
Chapter 10 represents her present.
Il-kapitlu 10 qed jirrappreżenta issa,
which is the rejection of God's way of salvation,
il-mod kif ġi rreġettat is-salvazzjoni tal-mulej.
And obviously the responsibilities that that Israel bears over this.
U allura qed jirrifletti wkoll il-responsabilità tal-għażla li qiegħda ġġorr.
And chapter 11 is about her future.
U kapitlu 11 qed jitkellem rigward il-futur tagħha.
And this reminds me of something. Isn't the scripture representing our past, present, and future also?
Il-skrittura mhijiex ukoll qiegħda tfakkarna illi qiegħda tirrappreżenta il-passat, il-present u il-futur tagħna?
That is the function of the Word of God.
Dik hija x-xogħol tal-kelma ta' Alla.
And so we have to work our way through this title of today, there is a remnant according to grace.
Allora hekk inkunu nistgħu nimxu fuq dan is-suġġett tal-fdal fil-grazzja ta' Alla.
So in verse 5 we see the word remnant.
Mela niltaqgħu mal-kelma fdal fil-vers 5.
I guess everybody knows what remnant means.
Naħseb kulħadd jaf x'qed tfisser din il-kelma.
But we have a definition here on screen.
Imma nistgħu naraw id-definizzjoni fuq l-iskrin.
So if we keep this in our mind, in our memory, the remnant of something is a small part of it that is left over when the main part has disappeared or been destroyed. That is the definition of the word remnant.
Definizzjoni tal-fdal huwa meta jibqalek xi ħaġa żgħira minn xi ħaġa ikbar illi baqgħet hemm meta l-ħaġa nfisha sparixxiet jew ġiet meqruda.
So there is the remnant, the people that that God is reserving for himself.
Hemm il-poplu illi Alla qiegħed iżomm għalih biss.
As we see in this chapter,
kif qed naraw f'dan il-kapitlu,
is a small remaining number of people.
Huwa numru ċkejken ta' nies.
But
imma
these people have remained faithful to God.
Din dawn il-ftit nies baqgħu fidili lejn Alla.
That's why they are called remnant.
Għalhekk jissejħu l-fdal.
So God here has allowed his people to reject the Messiah.
Naraw illi Alla ippermetta illi n-nies il-poplu jiċħad lill-Messija.
And at first sight it seems that the whole nation had turned his back on him.
U issa mal-ewwel ħarsa naraw illi qisu n-nazzjon kollu dawwar ħarsthom il-mulej.
But God, as usual, keeps his promises by saving a small part of the Jews as a remnant. This is what Paul is writing about here. And he gives us three examples to prove this. First of all, there is Paul himself, who is a Jew.
Jew inna niltaqgħu ma' Pawlu illi hu nnifsu huwa Ludi.
He refers to the prophet Elijah.
Jirreferi għall-profeta Elija.
And he even says the saved Jews we have today with us, who are Messianic Jews.
U qed jirreferi wkoll għal dawn il-Lut illi għadhom sammana llum li nsejħulhom il-Lut Messjaniċi.
Yes, Paul is doing this very clear that he is an Israelite, he is of the seed of Abraham and from the tribe of Benjamin.
And mod ċar Paolo qed jgħidilna li hu Israelit, li hu miż-żerrija ta' Abraham u mit-tribu ta' Benjamin.
So Paul is saying here, so if you think that God has rejected Israel, I am an Israelite and I am a Christian. So
jekk intom taħsbu qed jgħidilna Pawlu illi l-poplu kollu telqu lil Alla, jien Israelit. Jien Kristjan.
I am living proof that this is not true.
Jiena prova ċara li dan mhuwiex minnu.
And this happened to Elijah.
U dan ġara wkoll lil Elija.
When he ended up praying, as we saw in scripture, he ended up praying against Israel.
Spiċċa jitlob kontra Israel.
And he said, Lord, I am the only one left.
U talab imma
the only prophet.
L-unika wieħed li bqajt jien, l-unika profeta.
And God said, no.
Alla qallu le.
I reserved 7,000.
Jiena warrabt 7,000.
And obviously, normally the remnants are not really seen, but God has his plan, you know.
Is-soltu l-fdal ma tantx ikun jidher imma Alla kellu l-pjan tiegħu.
He reserved 7,000 who remained faithful to God.
Iva, Alla warrab 7,000 illi baqgħu fidili lejn Alla.
So whenever the nation of Israel was disobedient,
allura kull darba lin-nazzjoni Iżraelit kien disobedienti.
We can see this throughout scripture in the Old Testament.
Dan nistgħu niltaqgħu miegħu fit-Testament il-Qadim, tul il-Testament il-Qadim.
God had always kept aside a remnant for him.
Niltaqgħu u naraw illi dejjem Alla kellu dan il-poplu miġbur il-fdal, il-ftit.
Can you understand the point of Paul here?
Tistgħu tifhmuh il-punt ta' Pawlu hawnhekk?
And then Paul says, and today,
u Pawlu jgħidilna u llum,
and that today extends to us also.
U dik il-kelma llum issarraf għalina wkoll.
Jews are coming to Christ.
Lut et jorbu lejn Kristu.
Not as a nation, but individually.
Mhux bħala nazzjon, imma b'mod individwali.
So God is still choosing people there and then, individually. I call you, the ones who are faithful.
Alla, du qed jagħżel illum lilek, inti li lest tkun fidil.
Later on, Paul uses an analogy regarding the tree. But we're not going to see that today.
Paolo ktar qudiem jirreferi għas-siġra, ma mhux se niddiskutuha illum.
And there is a bit of a rebuke for us there.
U hemm twissija għalina fiha dik.
But we will see that later.
Imma dik niltaqgħu magħha iktar
ta'. So, brethren, if I may ask a question.
Allura aħwa, jekk insaqsikom mistoqsija.
Who is the remnant today?
Min hu l-fdal illum?
Who is the people of God today? Who are the people of God today?
Min huma wlied Alla illum?
Can you answer me?
Tistgħu tweġbuni?
Aħna l-Knisja. Those who are obedient.
Born again.
It is very important that we know who we are.
Huwa importantissimo li nkunu nafu aħna min aħna.
It is those who remain faithful.
Huma dawk li jibqgħu fidili.
In fact, Jesus says in Matthew 25,
f'Matteo 25, Ġesu jgħidilna hekk.
And those who remain faithful until the end,
dawk li jibqgħu fidili sal-aħħar,
will be saved.
Jkunu salvi.
So being born again is not something that has been done to us and that's all.
Il-fatt li aħna imwielda mill-ġdid mhix ġra darba u daqshekk.
But we have to make sure that we remain faithful.
Imma irridu nkunu ċerti li nibqgħu fidili.
And those are the remnant.
Dawk allura huma l-vera fdal.
And sometimes this happens to us, like Elijah. Lord, everyone is against you, I'm alone.
Xi kultant ngħidu aħna il-kliem ta' Elija mulej qegħdin waħedna ninsija.
Maybe we have a pity party or something like that.
Noqogħdu jiddispjaċina hekk
nagħmlu party. And God answers us, listen, it's under control.
U alla jweġibna u jgħidilna kollox fil-pjan tiegħi.
I am saving the remnant.
Qiegħed insalva l-ftit u l-fdal.
I am saving the ones who are responding to the gospel.
Qed insalva dawk li qed jirrispondu lejn il-kelma.
And you have to be a tool for that.
Intom tridu tkunu l-għodda għalhekk.
God is not doing the saving alone.
Alla mhuwiex qed jagħmel, mhux qiegħed isalva waħdu.
But God is saving the remnant through the church.
Imma Alla qiegħed isalva dawk il-magħżulin permezz tal-Knisja.
So if we can summarize here.
Allora jekk nistgħu niġbru kollox.
God had a remnant in Elijah's day.
Alla kellu il-fdal fi żmien Elija.
He had one in Paul's day.
Kellu wieħed fi żmien ta' Pawlu.
And he has one today.
U għandu wieħed illum.
Do you agree?
Taqblu miegħi?
So it's important that the scripture that we read and we study.
Importanti ħafna mela li l-iskrittura li nistudjaw u naqraw
is not only treated as history.
Ma nittrattawhiex bħala parti mill-istorja.
But it has to become reality for us.
Imma trid issir realtà.
Because the living word of God applies to us.
Għax il-kelma ħajja tal-mulej hija titkellem lilna wkoll illum.
In fact, when I was in Jerusalem, as I mentioned before,
fil-fatt meta jiena kont Ġerusalem kif għadtilkom qabel,
we happened to enter into this shop which sold antiques, I guess. It was antiques.
Tħallna f'ħanut li kien bih l-antikità.
And it was run by a church.
U kienet kien imexxi persuna li jmexxi knisja.
And they were messianic Jews.
U kienu lut messianici.
And we prayed together.
U tlabna flimkien.
And they gave us a prayer shawl also.
Tawna il-velu li jitolbu bihuma.
It was a marvelous experience.
Kienet esperienza sabiħa ħafna.
And they communicated with us.
U baqgħu jikkomunikaw magħna.
That their shop is normally vandalized by Jews.
Iva qalulna li s-soltu il-ħanut tagħhom ikun ivvandalizzat mill-lut.
Because they believe in Christ.
Għax huma jemnu fi Kristu.
So hardening of the heart, you understand that?
Tistgħu tifhmuha meta it-twebbis tal-qalb.
In fact, when Paul referred to grace and works.
Infatti meta Paolo jirreferi għal grazzja
in verse 6.
Verse 6.
We have to understand here that grace and works are mutually exclusive.
Irridu nifhmu li l-grazzja u l-kelma huma affarijiet esklusivi.
That means they don't happen simultaneously. They cannot happen together.
Ma jiġrux f'daqqa fl-istess ħin.
And Paul places it very, very clearly, and I would like to put this on the screen. And grace is something freely given to the undeserving.
Il-grazzja hija xi ħaġa li tingħata b'xejn lil dawk illi jifhmu.
And this definition helps us.
Sorry, mhux li jifhmu, dawk illi laqas huma worthy li ma jistħoqilhomx.
This definition of grace.
Di definizzjoni tal-grazzja
helps us to remain humble.
Tejna biex nibqgħu umli.
We do not deserve to be saved, brethren.
Ma jistħoqilniex li nkunu salvi.
We were the children of wrath.
Aħna konna it-tfal tar-rabja.
Tal-korla.
Tal-korla.
And through Christ we became the children of God.
Imma f'Ġesù sirna ulied Alla.
But through Christ has to be underlined.
Il-kliem min permezz ta' Ġesù irridu jkunu b'ħafna sinjali taħta.
It has to be emphasized.
Irridu nemfasizzawha.
Because the minute we think
għax dik il-minuta illi aħna naħsbu
that we deserve to be saved through works.
Li aħna nistgħu nkunu salvi biex xogħlijiet.
As Paul says it, grace will not remain grace.
Kif jgħidha Paolo, grazzja ma tibqax grazzja mbagħad.
It will be cancelled out.
Tiġi kkanċellata.
You understand that? It's like that is something that I am the first one that needs this. I need to remain humble.
Din nista' napplika għalija l-ewwel l-ewwel jiena nnifsi. Irrid nibqa' għumli.
And we all need that, I believe.
U kollha kemm aħna għandna bżonna.
You agree?
Nemmen.
Or am I just alone like Elijah? Yes, we need to remain humble, brethren, and we need to be people that support each other even when we maybe cross the line.
Irridu nżommu għumli u ninaqdu flimkien meta naslu f'ċertu deċiżjonijiet li nridu. Jew fil-ħajja spiritwalità.
In the last part of this text.
Fl-aħħar parti ta' dan it-text.
Paul is treating about how God has blinded Israel.
Paolo qed jitratta dwar kif Alla ama lill-Izraeliti.
I mean, we have to start from here. I mean, you know, God keeps his promises. That is one truth that we need to tackle.
Ejja nibdew minn hemm. Alla jżomma l-wegħdiet tiegħu. Irridu nżommu din f'moħħna, din l-iktar ħaġa importanti.
And he is sovereign.
Huwa sovran.
And scripture tells us that Israel as a whole has been temporarily set aside.
Għal mod għal żmien temporanju, il-kelma tal-la tgħidilna li Israel impoġġija fil-ġenb.
And as I said before, but individual Jews in the meantime are still being saved.
Imma fl-istess ħin persuni individwali lut qegħdin jiġu salvati.
So I ask another question. Why did God set his chosen people aside?
Għalfejn Alla poġġa fil-ġenb lin-nies magħżula tiegħu.
Even this helps us to remain humble.
Dan ukoll iżommna għomli.
As we see in the Old Testament stories,
kif nistgħu naqraw fit-Testament il-qadim,
the Jews were really good at this.
Il-Lut kienu tajbin ħafna fi qadim.
And I presume even we are.
U nista' ngħid illi anke aħna.
So whenever they cross the line,
allora kull darba li qasmu
cocktail. Whenever they cross the line, they suffer the consequences.
Kull darba li qabżu l-line, bataw il-konsekwenzi.
Doesn't this apply to us also today?
Matar għalina u kol din.
Well, well. He's the same God, isn't he?
Huwa l-istess Alla, le?
So, temporarily, because of their unbelief, they were set aside.
Minħabba li huma ma rridux jemnu, tpoġġew imwarba.
And this is part of his plan.
U dan huwa parti mill-pjan tiegħu.
I cannot answer why God wanted to do it this way, but
ma nistax inwieġeb ilgħala Alla oġbu jagħmlu b'dan il-mod.
The only answer I can give is
l-unika tweġiba li nista' nagħti
that his people, the people that were set aside, were hard-hearted.
L-unika ħaġa li nista' ngħid hija li l-poplu kien ta' qalbu wiebsa.
And I would like to make this really, really clear for us, because people will ask us probably this question. But how can God harden the hearts of people? So, as a principle, God will let the heart of those who persist in unbelief to be hardened. That is the biblical principle.
Il-prinċipju bibliku u illi Alla jippermetti lill-qalb ta' dawk illi jibqgħu jippersistu fi li ma jridux jemnu se jibqa' jġala issir iktar jibsa.
That is scary.
Hija naqra tal-biża.
It is scary. This is the same God who is love.
Dan huwa l-istess Alla li huwa mħabba.
That we are talking about.
Li qegħdin nitkellmu dwaru.
So it's good to balance God's characteristics.
Hemmhekk huwa tajjeb illi nibbilanċjaw il-karakteristiċi.
Because he is a just God also.
Għax huwa Alla ġust.
And he keeps his promises.
U iżomm il-wegħdiet tiegħu.
He will not go against his promises.
Ma jmurx kontrihom.
And there's an advantage, we have them written.
U mod għall-vantaġġ tagħna huma miktuba.
Can you appreciate that?
Tistgħu tapprezzawha din?
Many Old Testament, New Testament early Christians.
Kristjani tal-ewwel Knisja
did not yet have all this plan, God's plan written down.
Mhux kienu ta' għandhom dal-pjan kollu miġbur miktub.
The Jews had the Old Testament, yes.
Il-Lut iva kellhom it-Testament il-qadim.
But the Gentile Christians did not have the New Testament, the New Testament.
Imma l-Gentili qas kien għad għandhom it-Testament il-ġdid.
So they were still depending on the message of the church at that time.
Allora kienu għadhom qegħdin jimxu fuq il-messaġġ li kien qed tagħhom il-Knisja.
So this is the privilege that we have today, brethren, that we have it written down.
Il-privilege tagħna huwa li aħna għandna bil-miktub.
And I would like to quote Psalm 81, verse
12.
Just two verses down from your from what you quoted, Masha, today. And scripture says this: so I let them follow their own stubborn desires, living according to their own ideas.
Iżda, għalhekk tlaqthom għall-ebbusija ta' qalbhom biex imxew skont il-femijiet tagħhom.
And this is regarding the Jews. So in that context, that God hardens the heart of the
unbeliever.
So it's like, if you see it in a wider context, you will understand what's happening here. In fact, I planned to put this on screen, but I don't think I did this. But this is very important for us to, because it is very balanced the way we the way I'm trying to explain it to you. So it says this: they don't refuse to believe because they are hardened. Oh, there it is. I thought I did not do it. They don't refuse to believe because they are hardened. Rather, they are hardened because they refuse to believe. So that is a better picture of God, how God is working with the people who are stubborn.
Nistgħu nifhmu aħjar kif Alla qiegħed jaħdem ma' dawk in-nies illi jissupervjaw u ma jridux iradbu l-qalb tagħhom. Naqraw hekk. Huma mhux jirrifjutaw illi jemnu għaliex huma mwebsa, imma huma mwebsa għaliex huma jirrifjutaw illi jemnu.
So the minute God lifts up his hand on those who are being guided today by the Holy Spirit to come to the gospel.
Kif Alla jerfa' jiedu minn dawk, minn fuq dawk illi qegħdin jiġu qed jiġu mresqa l quddiem mill-Spiritu Santu
to receive the gospel,
biex jirċievu il-kelma,
it would be impossible for that person to receive the gospel.
Sejkun diffiċli u impossibbli għal dik il-persuna biex tirċievi.
God is at work through the Holy Spirit in a way that we do not know.
Fil-mod li aħna ma nistgħux nifhmu, Alla qed jaħdem bl-Ispirt, fl-Ispirtu.
And I know this and I keep this in my heart. If it wasn't for Jesus Christ on the cross for me, I will just be the son of wrath. The son of the wrath of God, that is. But to keep myself humble, I know that I have to depend on what Jesus Christ has done for us, for me, especially.
Biex nżomm li l-nifsi jom li rrit nibqa, niftakar f'dak kollu li jagħmel Ġesu għalija, għalina.
This will keep us humble.
Da żgur li jżomna omli.
And when I heard the message today regarding our service,
meta smajt il-messaġġ dwar is-servizz fil-Knisja,
It struck me in the heart.
Laqtet lil-qalbi.
Not because it is the only church that is going through this.
Mhux għax hija l-unika knisja li għaddejja minn dan.
But sometimes, brethren, we tend to forget.
Imma xi kultant ninsew.
What we are commissioned for.
X'aħna msejħa biex nagħmlu.
We are the children of God now.
Aħna ulied Alla.
And God needs us to build his church.
U Alla għandu bżonna biex nibnu l-knisja tiegħu.
This is not a lounge, a comfortable VIP room.
Da mhux post komdu fejn qogħdu komdi.
This should be the church in action.
Di għandha tkun il-knisja fl-azzjoni.
And we are the bodies, we are the members of this body.
Aħna l-membri ta' dan il-ġisem.
So if we are the remnant,
allura jekk aħna l-fdal
that God has kept for himself,
li Alla żamm għalih innifsu,
as faithful to him,
il-fidili hekk, il-fidili leh miegħu,
don't you think we have to live that faithfulness?
Ma taħsbux li għandna nejxuh dak il-fidi?
Don't you think that we have to reciprocate to him through us being active members in the church?
Manix nirreċiprokaw, nirreċiprokaw dan billi nkunu membri attivi fil-Knisja.
And that obviously includes everyone in here.
Dik tinkludi lil-kulħadd.
We are not pointing fingers here.
Bla ma nippuntaw subajna.
There is always room for progress. Always.
Dejjem spazju fejn nikbru.
And I know that God knows.
Jiena naf li Alla jaf.
That we are weak.
Li aħna dajfa.
And we need God to walk with us in our own pace.
U nafu li Alla jaf li irrid jimxi magħna bil-pass tagħna.
But if we get lazy,
imma jekk nitgħażlu,
he will scold us.
Say what say chan fire.
And we would deserve that, wouldn't we? And that is part of becoming a discipleship.
Discipline.
So I really would like to encourage us all. That we will be able to apply the word of God in our lives. This small part of Romans 11 has a lot to talk about. We still have 2/3 of chapter 11 to go for. But it is not only treating this text as history.
Maħniex qed nittrattaw din parti tal-iskrittura bħala storja,
but treating it as an instruction.
Bħala istruzzjoni.
To us today.
Aħna llum.
Because it is the living word of God.
Għax hija l-ħajja kelma ta' Alla.
Amen.
Amen.